180s and rotational tricks off the wake are great stepping stone tricks. These are the tricks that you want to try and get down before you get into the more advanced inverts, flips, Raleys. Whenever you're going to do a rotational trick, try to always remember that the rotation comes from the hips. If you imagine that there's a rod going through your hips and you're always going to take the end of the rod and point it the direction that you want to go. When you're doing the 180s, try to leave the wake first, reach your peak. Once you've reached your peak, then rotate the hip, point it in the direction that you were traveling. You'll land it and the board will stick to the water nicely. Once you learn it to do the regular way, learn it switch. If you can get the 180 one way, the 180 switch, this will give you a good stepping stone, good foundation, and you're ready to start getting into inverts. Once you get the 180s down, let's try to put a little style to it and grab it. You want to get in the air first, again, the same as we did before. Once you've peaked out, remember you want to bring the board to your hand, not the hand to the board. Get all your height, suck the knees in, grab the board. You can go for indie, or method, or crail, or whatever you want. The trick is, it's style, so create your own. Raley, the trick that everybody wants to learn. Why? It impresses people. It's cool. Everybody loves them. The Raley's 95% mental, 5% physical. Once you can make your mind convince your body you're not gonna die, you'll be fine. The trick to the Raley is an extremely hard edge, but the hard edge has got to continue through the top of the wake. Everybody thinks they're gonna start hard. If you do that, you'll have nothing by the time you get to the wake. Progressive, the key word. Start easy, build through the top. When you're leaving the top of the wake, imagine that you're standing on a carpet and somebody's gonna rip the carpet out from underneath your feet. You're not gonna advance to the boat, you're gonna advance away from the boat. Get to the top of the wake with that hard edge, lift the handle up to about eye level and let everything drift behind it. When you get in the air, try to make eye contact with the boat. This will square off your shoulders and keep you nice and tight for the landing. The air Raley, the coolest trick out. For our advanced trick, we're gonna work on the Slurpee and the wrecking ball. Gotta thank Zane Schwenk for both of these. Hardest part of the Slurpee is the cut in. You wanna get wide outside the wake and wrap that handle in behind your back. The biggest trick is once that handle gets behind your back, of controlling it. You wanna get that handle tight to your back and try to keep your shoulders really arched and tall. Let yourself drift in, let the rope pull you in. You don't have to do any cutting. The second you put that handle behind your back, it'll take off. Edge in slowly at the top of the wake, try to hold on with that backhand until you leave the top of the wake. As you leave, you're gonna let go with your lead hand and let the rope unwrap you. As soon as you take off, start turning your head to spot the handle. Once you can spot it, pass it to the other hand. Pull your body in, again finishing the trick with your hips first. As you come down to the water and you land, look up. Look to the horizon and the direction that you want to travel. And you'll stick the Slurpee. The wrecking ball, named after Matt Hickman. This is a trick where you come in wrapped, and it's the exact same rotation as a Moby Dick, except you're going to wrap up for it. The trick is, whenever you're coming in on a wrap trick, to not lean into the wrap. Once you lean into the wrap, it puts you on your back foot. Back foot takeoff makes a back foot landing. When you get wrapped up, hold the peg in close to your body and try to keep as much weight on your front foot as you possibly can. The wrap does the 360 for you. You don't want to think about doing the 360. The second you turn your head, you'll spin too quick. Leave the top of the wake holding onto the peg. Look straight up. Don't think three, think nothing but tantrum. When you get upside down, the rope will start unwrapping you. As you feel your landing coming, spot the water, grab with the other hand. Damn, you just made a wrecking ball.